David Sinclair is a well-known Harvard professor researching aging and the author of the book Lifespan. Over the years, he's developed a protocol based on trial and error and the latest scientific evidence to improve his health and extend his lifespan. Aside from feeling healthier and younger, he can tell what interventions are or are not working by measuring biomarkers, especially his epigenetic age. Over the past few years, he has decreased his biological age by nearly 20 years, suggesting that his body is aging slower than his chronological age of 52. Despite this, he's always looking to further improve his health and reduce his biological age. And like all of us, he's even made some mistakes that have negatively impacted his health. Here are the 7 changes David has recently made to his longevity protocol. Stick around till the end to see what Sinclair added that is having the biggest impact on longevity. Sinclair has recently added an amino acid supplement to his longevity arsenal, which on the surface might seem as odd because Sinclair is a firm believer that lower protein intake is best to improve health and longevity. His thoughts are largely based on studies showing that mice fed low protein diets or the low amount of certain amino acids like methionine live longer. The theory is that protein, especially certain amino acids, activate the mTOR signaling pathway in our cells, causing us to age quicker. So if we eat less protein, we'll activate mTOR less and age slower as a result. Paradoxically, a recent study showed that mice supplemented with a specific amino acid, taurine, that activates mTOR live longer. Based on this study and the low health risk profile of taking amino acid supplements, Sinclair changed his mind and added taurine to his regimen. He currently takes 2 milligrams of taurine per day.
Please subscribe for more content.
Because of the many hats that Sinclair wears, including being a researcher, author, podcaster, and entrepreneur, Sinclair's sleep often suffers. Sleep is emerging as an underappreciated critical piece to long-term health and longevity. A large prospective study of over 172,000 U.S. adults showed that men and women who have high-quality sleep live nearly 5 and 2.5 years longer compared to those who have poor quality sleep, respectively. Although he understands the health and longevity benefits of high-quality sleep, he would often only get around 6 hours of sleep per night, at best. But recently, Sinclair decided to make high-quality sleep a priority. Sinclair has made adjustments to sleep by meditating for at least 10 minutes before bed, avoiding screen time 2 to 3 hours before going to bed, darkening his room, cooling his bed, and taking supplements, including magnesium. He now aims for 7 to 8 hours of sleep per night. In addition to fine-tuning his sleep routine, Sinclair has made a recent change to his morning routine. The change he made was to improve the bacteria in his mouth, the oral microbiome. If you weren't aware, we have several microbiomes, in addition to the gut microbiome, living with us, and each of them play key roles in determining our health and lifespan. One of the lesser known microbiomes that has an important role in dictating our health is the oral microbiome, composed of viruses, fungi, and over 700 different species of bacteria. Poor oral microbiome health not only raises your chance of gum disease, it also is strongly linked to cardiovascular disease, cancer, Alzheimer's disease, and arthritis. Based on these emerging findings, Sinclair has adopted a protocol to help the beneficial mouth bacteria thrive. In the morning, he rinses his mouth with coconut oil, a process called oil pulling, which reduces the amount of harmful bacteria, plaque, and gingivitis in the mouth. He then brushes his teeth with a non-toxic toothpaste to make sure he doesn't pollute his body with compounds like fluoride, parabens, triclosan, sodium lauryl sulfate, propylene glycol, and so on. Another thing that Sinclair changed his mind on is coffee, which he recently stopped drinking. While there is evidence that coffee has health properties, it hasn't been shown to provide long-term health benefits like some types of teas. He replaced his daily coffee with matcha tea, a type of green tea that contains a life-prolonging molecule called EGCG for short. EGCG has been shown to extend health and lifespan partly by blocking DNA damage and inflammaging. The fifth change that Sinclair has made is drop one of the most commonly used drugs in the world, alcohol. Sinclair used to have a glass of wine and whiskey many evenings, but recent studies have shown that even small amounts of alcohol can have negative health effects. Alcohol is a known carcinogen, and its consumption is linked to an increased risk of various cancers, including those of the liver, breast, and esophagus. Over time, alcohol use takes a toll on our livers, leading to conditions such as fatty liver, hepatitis, cirrhosis, and even at low levels of intake. There's evidence that it weakens the immune system, making individuals more susceptible to infections. Alcohol is also associated with mental health issues, including depression and anxiety, and can impair cognitive function and memory. Equally alarming is that alcohol consumption is a leading cause of accidents and injuries. Considering these health risks, David decided to completely drop alcohol from his diet. During the pandemic, David was under a lot of stress professionally and personally, leading to episodes of depression. Some of his colleagues have been criticizing him for his bold claims that he makes regarding therapies aimed at treating aging, like resveratrol and epigenetic reprogramming. His other major stressor was that in 2022, David was going through a divorce with his wife, Sandra. Studies have shown that individuals reporting lower happiness levels face nearly double the mortality rate over the subsequent 5 years compared to their happier counterparts. This association persisted even after accounting for variables such as health, finances, and depression, with the happiest individuals exhibiting a 35% lower risk of death. Happier individuals maintain better physical function and experience slower declines in walking speed. Happiness even influences your immune system, affecting your susceptibility to get sick. Despite the turmoil in his life, David did not fret. He doubled down on his research, producing more publications, and moved on from his marriage. As a result, last year he was elected the president of the Academy for Health and Lifespan Research by his peers, and he found a new partner, Selena Poon, both of which contributed to him in restoring his happiness levels. Sinclair takes many supplements to improve his health and lifespan, some that are very controversial, like resveratrol because of its debated effectiveness in the longevity community, and metformin because it's a prescription drug for diabetics that can have negative consequences on muscle mass. He recently added another controversial drug to his protocol, rapamycin. Rapamycin is controversial because it's a prescription drug which is primarily used to prevent organ transplant rejection. Sinclair has previously said that he did not take rapamycin because of the potential negative effects, including low platelet and white blood cell counts, anemia, and mouth sores. But over the past few years, several studies have emerged showing the powerful benefits of rapamycin at low doses to improve health and extend lifespan. For example, rapamycin is the only drug known to extend lifespan in all animal models tested. It has also been shown to prevent age-related conditions in dogs, primates, and humans. The strong evidence, which have many experts touting rapamycin as the best anti-aging drug currently available, together with the relatively low risk of side effects at low doses, convinced Sinclair to recently start using it. If you want to see the other interventions that Sinclair uses, watch this video. Or check out these videos about emerging therapies that will truly revolutionize how we age.